Hey guys, I'm Chris and welcome to iStalker. In this video, you'll learn how to create an awesome 3D text in Photoshop CC. So hit the like and let's start the tutorial. I'm gonna create a new document with a 1920 by 1080 pixels. This creates a white background layer for me. Then I hit Shift plus F5 to open the Fill dialog, which can be also accessed by going to Edit, Fill. And from this dropdown, I choose to fill my layer with a 50% gray. I'm doing this because I can easily modify 50% gray color and turn it into any color I want later. I hit T to create a new text layer and I'm just gonna write in sunset. Then I'm gonna hold down Shift and rotate the text to 15 degrees just to make it more interesting, and I take my time to reposition it exactly as I want on the background layer. Now I right click on the text layer and choose new 3D extrusion from selected layer. You'll see that the text becomes 3D and it has already an extrusion. I have a new tab open here called 3D where I have all the elements from the scene. The next step is to go back to the layers tab, right click on the background layer, choose postcard, and Photoshop will make this layer a 3D object as well. I'm gonna select both layers holding down Shift, go to 3D and press on Merge 3D Layers. Let's go back to the 3D tab here where I have all these elements one by one. It could be a bit confusing if this is your first time when you're using 3D in Photoshop, but I'm sure you're gonna get used to it fast. If I select Sunset Front Inflation Material, I can go up here and change the front color of my text. So I click on Diffuse and I enter my favorite color, 40 for the hue, 100 for the saturation, and 100 for brightness. I will also choose 60% for shine, 15% for reflection, and 0 for bump. I also want to change the specular color, so I enter 46, 11, 69. I already tested these values, that's why I just entered them here. So I hit OK. Also, if I select this layer called Sunset Extrusion Material, I can change the color of the extrusion, this white part. So I go up here to the diffuse color and I change it to a dark gray. 0, 0, and 20. I will make sure that shine is at 20% and bump at 0. Now the text looks good and you can see it better in the front of the gray background. If I go here to this icon, I can click and drag the mouse to orbit to rotate the camera around the whole scene, and by doing this, I can see that the extrusion of the text is so deep that the background layer is cutting it in half. I'm gonna fix this by selecting the sunset text layer, go to the extrusion depth slider and change its value to 4. I can select both layers with Shift and click on Align Left Edges up here. Okay, now I will go back to the default view for my camera. I just right click here in this area and click Default. In fact, I can create even a custom view. So let's say, for example, that I want to go higher with the camera. Right click here, save, give it a name, and then click save. Now, if I start to orbit again and change the camera position, I can always go back to view one. It can happen that the back wall, the background, is a bit smaller than the camera frame. If this happens, make sure you select the background layer. You select this tool which allows you to scale 3D objects, and you just click and push the mouse to make the object bigger. I want to zoom in on one of the letters because I need to add some details here. I will add a bevel to the front inflation material, so the front of the text. I click on the sunset text layer and then choose this bevel button. 45 degrees angle is okay, and I will put a 15 for the bevel. But as you can see, this is a bit too much, so I will lower the value to, let's say, 7. It looks much better now. Going back to the default view again, I can choose a color for the bevel separately, so I will click on the front bevel material and change the diffuse color to a black. And I will also set this material to reflect light, so I enter 70 on reflection, 70 for shine, and 60 for roughness. Now, if I go back to the environment layer and look at the top where the IBL is, I can see that I have a global light which will cast some very smooth shadows on the objects. Let me do a quick render for you. And before doing that, If I want my render to be faster, what I can do is to press Ctrl K to open my preferences, go to 3D, set the shadow quality to medium, and the high quality threshold to 3. These settings are for a faster rendering. We will get back here before doing the final high quality render. Press OK and let's do a quick render. I will press this icon here. I'm also speeding up the video right now because we have some other things to do as well in this tutorial. So as you can see, the image is a bit noisy, and that's normal because it's a draft render, it's a preview. But this is how the light and the shadows make this 3D text look good. At the moment, the light in the scene comes from all directions, but I want to limit the light to come from above only, just like a big softbox. For this, I will use some options from the Environment tab. I click here near the IBL color and choose New Texture. Click OK here and then click again on this icon and choose Edit Texture. Photoshop will open a new white document and basically this will be my light from the scene. I press Ctrl I to invert the layer from white to black. Then I grab the rectangular marquee tool and create a selection here, about 1/3 from the total height of the frame. I press Shift plus F5 and from this drop-down I choose Color and write in again my favorite values, 40, 100 and 100. Click OK and this will add a warm orange light to the whole scene. Imagine this document wrapped around a sphere. The orange rectangle will become a nice orange circle above all the objects from the scene, just like a huge softbox that will cast smooth shadows. I go back to the main file now, which is already updated with this IBL texture. Next, I select the background and make sure I have the shine at 0, bump at 0, and a 15% of reflection. I want to reflect a part of this IBL texture that I just made. What I can do now is to select the environment layer, and immediately after that, I can see this sphere and the light which is coming from above at the moment. The light is reflected in this sphere. The cool part is that I can hold down my mouse and reposition the light. And because the text that I entered here is sunset, I can simulate a sunset scene by changing the angle of the light source, and by doing that, it will reflect in the background wall. It looks like the sun is behind a hill at the horizon, and this creates a kind of a sunset scene where the sun is very low and there is some shade on the text. So I reposition my light source, and the next step is to render my scene. I'm not done yet, because after the render, I will tweak the colors, so stick with the video. I enter the preferences again with Ctrl K, go to 3D, for shadow quality I choose high, and for high quality threshold I choose 7. Also, I make sure that the render tile size is set to medium. Hit OK, and I click this render button. It's gonna take a long time until this render is ready, so I need to speed up the things here. Meanwhile, don't forget to press the like on this video, because this way you make me understand that you really enjoy watching it and you'll get me a boost of motivation to create more tutorials for you. Also, you could check out my Instagram at iStalker. I post travel and nature photos there, so give me a follow. You'll also get updated when I post a new YouTube video. Okay, the render is ready, so the next step is to apply some color effects on this. I would like to work non-destructively in case I want to come back to the 3D scene, so what I will do is to hit Ctrl A to select all, Ctrl C to copy this image, then go to New, choose Clipboard, press Create, and then press Ctrl V to paste the rendered image. I go to the adjustment layers and add a selective color. I'm gonna choose neutrals and I will change the background color to a blue tone. So I'm gonna bring cyan to 100%, magenta to minus 10, and yellow to minus 85. Next, I'm adding a new hue saturation adjustment layer, change the hue to minus 5, and raise the saturation up to 15. Let's add a levels adjustment as well. I want to brighten up the midtones and increase the highlights. I will add some noise as a final step, so I create a new layer, which will stay on top here, then I hit Shift plus F5 to open the Fill menu and choose 50% gray. I go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Field Blur, choose the Noise tab here, I enter 30 for the amount, 25 for size, and 50 for roughness. Hit OK, put this layer on overlay blending mode and lower its opacity to 40%. Right now I can select all the adjustment layers and the noise layer, hit Ctrl G to group them, and this will make it easier for me to check the before and after. So as you can see, these effects are creating a huge difference. This is the final image, guys. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to the channel for more tutorials. And I want to give a big shout out to this Instagram account for commenting on one of my photos yesterday. Make sure you check it out. I'm Chris, have an awesome day, and see you next time.